I'm Sophia Rubio, and welcome back to the Maynard Legacy. Today, my group takes you on a journey through a unique dining experience with Dining in the Dark. Johnny breaks down one of the varsity football's top plays of the season. The Uncovered and Undiscovered tells a story about Milli Vanilli and their lip-syncing disaster. Cam shares some unused animations and absent storyboard. But first, let's debut an all-new segment from Adam Kishak, where he discusses all things anime. This is episode 3 of the Maynard Legacy. Let's get into it.
And today we're going over the 3 best new gen anime of the last 2 years. Tokyo Revengers is one of the hottest animes in the world right now, with record-breaking sales, with over 1 million copies sold in the previous week. The basis of the show is where Takemichi, the main character, travels back in time to save his dead girlfriend. This is currently one of my favorite shows being made right now. Next we have Demon Slayer, currently the most popular sword fighting show in the world right now due to its incredible animations and action sequences. Tanjiro, a 16-year-old boy who becomes a Demon Slayer to avenge his family and slay every demon that he comes across. In my opinion, this show will become number one quite soon. Last, we have Jujutsu Kaisen, which was released in 2020 and is the most popular anime in production right now. Itadori, a 17-year-old athletically tuned student, consumes a curse. By joining a school where they learn actually how to fight curses, he becomes stronger every single day. Thank you for tuning in, and now back to the studio.
Welcome back to today's Maynard Breakdown. Today I'm going to be looking at a play from the Bishop Fenwick game. We're going to come out in a 3x1 formation, which means we're going to have 3 receivers to one side of the screen and 1 receiver to the other. We want to try to attack this area of the field right here because there's no defender in it, and we're going to do so by running a slant into that window. We're going to fake the run action, as you can see here. And when we fake the run action, it's going to bring this linebacker up, opening up that void even more. By the time he sees us a pass, the ball is almost ready to be released. Because the corner, who was initially here, bails, and this linebacker gets sucked up with the run, the slant has plenty of room to operate. All he has to do is catch the ball, and that's going to set up a third and manageable. Here in the end zone copy, you get a good idea of how much space horizontally we have to work with. So that slant has plenty of room to work. Especially when this corner drops back, he comes up to play the run as soon as we fake it. We fake the run, the ball is out, all he has to do is beat the defender to the spot and box him out, put his body between him and the ball. He makes the catch and falls forward, and that's going to set up our next play. 2 plays later, we come out in the same formation. We have 3 receivers to one side, 1 receiver to the other, and we're going to have the running back right here. Because we've already run that slant, now we're going to try to hit him with a slant and go, which is exactly what it sounds like. We're going to run a slant, and then as soon as the quarterback pump fakes, we're going to go. This corner's going to bite. Here, we don't fake the run action. That's because we don't need to try to create this window right here, because we're not trying to actually hit the slant. He gives a little pump fake. Let's see it from the end zone copy. Here's the pump fake, and as soon as we give the pump fake, that corner's going to come up. And you can see he sells the slant, and then he breaks off. Corner comes up, and at this point, corner is going towards the ball, while our wide receiver is going away from the ball. The only thing the corner can do is try to get the hands in here, which is going to draw a holding penalty, which essentially gives us a free play, as we either get a completion, or we get 15 yards on the penalty. All he has to do is, because he's got him beat vertically, is drop the ball over the shoulder. It's a good ball and a good catch, and right there you can see the flag thrown, but unfortunately, he gets caught from behind and pushed out of bounds. However, this is still a 44-yard gain, and one of the few big plays in this game for Maynard. That's all for this episode of Maday's Maynard Breakdown. I'm John Maday, signing out.
Fab Morvan and Rob Paladis, the German and French R&B duo from Munich, Germany, known as Milli Vanilli. In 1988, they were approached by someone named Frank Farian, who offered them $4,000, and them being poor at the time, accepted to be the face of a new singing duo. Milli Vanilli took the world by storm, selling 7 million copies of their debut album, The Hits That Shocked the World. But they only lasted 2 years, and very quickly went from the most famous to the most infamous duo in music history, and here's why.
Despite being caught lip-syncing their songs, they went on to win 3 AMAs in the January of 1990.
And the winner is, girl, you know it's true, Milli Vanilli!
After winning their 3 AMAs, they went on to win a Grammy a month later. Fab and Rob then demanded they sing on the next album, but their manager said no.
This was due to the fact that they were currently under fire for being exposed, and the music would have sounded much different with different singers on the album.
Soon after their manager had said no to them singing on the next album, their record label was dropped from Arista Records.
Their Grammy was later revoked, and they were in danger of a lawsuit from their enraged fan.
Rob Paladis unfortunately died at the age of 33 in Frankfurt, Germany.
One of the Ghost singers, John Davis, died of COVID-19 in Germany. Fab Morvan then tried to start a solo comeback.
He made his solo comeback in the early 2000s, releasing his album called Love Revolution. It never turned out good for him, but he now works as a DJ in Amsterdam and Los Angeles.
Here's my co-host, Jamie Butler.
Hi guys! As you know, from this episode, we are going to be reviewing the cool and crazy Dining in the Dark experience, and let's take it to Sophia for more info.
Thanks, Jamie! Located in Boston, Massachusetts, the Hampshire House restaurant includes a vast variety of food, such as seafood, meat, and vegan options. When you go to the restaurant, it will cost you $90. Then you will be seated at a table and immediately blindfolded.
And now that we're back in the studio, we're going to get some food and recreate this Dining in the Dark experience.
We're going to start off by shutting off the lights. Okay, now that we're back with the lights off and our blindfolds on, we're ready to try our Market Basket sushi.
Yeah, and I have my California rolls. Beth has her vegetable rolls. We've got some soy sauce. And we're just going to dive right in. It's said that if you take one of your senses away, the others are enhanced. So we're going to see if this food tastes any different, any better, any worse, and we'll let you guys know.
So after trying the food with my blindfold on, I can definitely tell a difference. The flavors are very enhanced.
Yeah, I would say I could taste the ingredients a lot, they were a lot stronger.
So yeah, and now we're going to kick it to our future selves to end out our video.
Thank you guys so much for watching this episode of
The To-Go Show.
Restaurants around the world.
Stay tuned in for next week's video.
Grandpa, can you tell me a story of your past?
What did I tell you about interrupting my beauty sleep, you ingrate? I'll tell you the legend
of the Bionicle.
Everyone, I have an announcement to make. There's been a scandal.
Isn't that you pay the refs off?
What? No. It's that I'm actually